Today, where are we? Aptask Pune. And what are we going to learn today? We're going to learn sales. Your words change. Instead of saying, let me see what I can do. Right. He said, so powerful it is. The moment you're saying, let me see what I can do, or let me see what I can do to serve you better. Let me see how I can serve you.
Help you,
serve you. Help is usually the understated or overused word. Let me see how I can help you. Overused. So, kya dimag ko sunne ki aadat lagi, you don't weightage. There's no heavy weight to that. But the moment you say, let me see how I can serve you, the other person is like, okay. The person is different, okay? And then your language of this also should be like this. You know, at Aptask, we believe in serving our clients so that you get the best of the resources in your organization. Something like that. It has to ingrained in the way you talk, way you walk, everything, right? Serving language. Okay, what else? To build your confidence, you need to build your competence. Wonderful. Like if you don't know how to talk and what to say, obviously, you will not have confidence. Accept your failure and rejection. In fact, love them. Love them. Somebody rejects you. Thank you so much. Thank you for rejecting me. I'm one step closer to getting accepted. One more step, because that's how it is. No, 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 yes. So when you start getting no, 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 you're getting closer, closer to yes. But in the mind, people think no, no, no means forever no. I'll keep getting no. Right? So it's a one step. So you should thank them. Thank you. Thank you for telling me. That now you know that you're not going to spend your time, effort, energy there. Of course, you'll do your best to convince that person with whatever I'm going to teach you later in next few sessions. But yes, don't be afraid of your failures. Okay. What else?
Fear of rejection.
Fear of rejection. Okay. What should we do with that? So if you have fear, let's say somebody has a fear of rejection, what is the solution that you should suggest them? Gain the knowledge, okay, good.
Believe
in yourself, okay. So here's the four stages I was talking to you about. We spoke about the top stage. People will not be afraid of rejection. Those are the people with the high self-esteem, right? This is the high self-esteem. This is what we all need. When you're going to propose a girl or a guy, you need a high self-esteem. Right? Imagine you walking up to a guy or a girl and you're so nervous, your hands are shaking, you're drowsing, you're sweating, and you're like, can I buy you a drink? What is your name? Can you please What would a girl say? Get lost, creepo. Right? Nobody wants to hang out with people who have the low self-esteem. But the thing is, a lot of people don't understand what is the root cause of low self-esteem or lack of self-esteem. A lot of people don't understand this. If you understand this, the root cause of it, you can correct it. A lot of people think, okay, I need more self-esteem. I need more high self-esteem. But how do I get there? Why is it happening? I don't even know. Okay, how do I have high self-esteem? Right? I have seen some people, when they get rejection on the phone, they said, ha, kya hua? Na bol diya mere ko. They're happy about it. And I said, the dunya khatam ho gayi. Lost. I don't know what I'll do. Low self-esteem. Right? So self-esteem comes from, so the high self-esteem can only come from everybody together. Come from
self-confidence.
When you believe in yourself, that's where you get the self-confidence. So where does the self-confidence comes from? Self-belief. So if I have self-belief, will I be self-confident? Yes, if I believe in myself, I will be. So even if you give me 10 rejection, 100 rejection, I don't care. I believe in myself and I believe in what I have to offer. So your self-belief in yourself, your abilities, as well as your belief in Aptask. Your belief in what you're doing is great. Your belief has to be strong. Then you will have self-confidence, then you'll have self-esteem. And when you have self-esteem, there's no room for fear. There's no room for nervousness. There's no room for anxiety. You will not have butterfly in your stomach. You'll be like a machine. Kuch farak hi nahi padta hai. Rejection. Arre karo, reject karo, reject karo, reject karo, reject karo. I don't care. I'll make more calls. Where would the self-belief come from? Anybody?
Mindset.
Okay, very close. Very close. This comes from... It comes from?
Self-image.
It comes from?
Self-image.
Comes from?
Self-image.
This is the root. This is the root cause of why people are more... Some people are very nervous and some people are very confident. We think that, oh, they are born that way. No. Something has happened when they were kids, when they were the way they were brought up. That's what decided how self-image would be. Some people were brought up making them believe that they're not good enough. Some people are brought up with the way of inferiority. That why can't you be so good? Look at Sharma ji ka beta. What is wrong with you? You fail. Dimag mein kyun nahi jata? And then, at the age of 6 or 7 or 8, self-belief, self-image is strong. I mean, it's formed when you're 7 or 8. And poor people, poor you do not even know what your environment did to you, what your parents did to you unknowingly,
subconsciously.
And that's what you became the byproduct of weak self-image. So if I have weak self-image, what will it be?
Weak
self-belief. If I have weak self-belief, then?
Weak
self-confidence or low self-confidence. Okay, low confidence. If I have low confidence, then?
Low
self-esteem. Low self-esteem. That's why you see, India mein especially, chote aur bado mein itna fark hota hai. Ameer aur gareeb mein itna fark hota hai that gareeb will always be my baap, my baap, my baap. It's not just in the movies. Why? Because they have low self-image. They think that they are here and the other rich people or successful people are here. Even the education system did that. If you are not educated, your self-image is here. And you look up to somebody, oh, God. Even if you are from vernacular language. How many of you are from not English medium school? Raise your hand. Wow, only two. I mean, you guys deserve a round of applause. Because it's very difficult if you're not from English medium to work in an English environment where you have to talk to the foreigners. It's so bloody difficult. You have to work really hard on this because you're always feeling inferior. Somebody's talking English. You seen Super 30 movie? How many seen Super 30 movie? Who was that? Ritik Roshan, Super 30. You should watch it. It's a great movie. Like, I watch these inspirational movies. Don't go for commando movies. That's where the self-image comes into picture. Now that you know the root cause, can we change the self-image?
Yes.
Yes. How would you change the self-image? Yes, with your belief. How would you change your belief?
Preparing yourself.
How would you prepare yourself?
Acquiring knowledge.
Okay, one more, what else?
I am a champion.
Yeah, give our applause! Now you see why I'm teaching you what I'm teaching you. You think that, arey, ye self-image, self-confidence, ye kahan sales mein sikhata hai koi? Nahi sikhate, iske liye to mostly sales people mediocre rehte hain. Most of the sales people remain weak because they don't know what the root cause is. So that's why it's so important to wake up every morning and yell out loud, multiple times, I'm a champion, I'm a champion, I'm a champion. Because when you wake up in the morning, your brains are at the highest peak of learning and growing. Highest peak. Most creative, most productive are the highest. The second best time also to use those affirmation called I'm a champion is when you're about to sleep. Because what's going to happen is, when you repeat whatever you say, have you seen like some of the movies, you saw some horror movies and you had horrible dreams? How many of you had that? Right? You had the nightmares because you did that at the night to get scared and enjoy that fun, right? And when you do that, what you did last stays in your brain, in your subconscious mind. So it projects only those negative and evil images. Like this movie, right? Which was that? Ram Gopal Varma, where you know they're scared. Urmila Matolkar wala.
Ghost.
Nahi, ghost nida.
Booth.
Yes, booth. Yes. And then translation bola. It's an English session, so he said go booth. Ghost. All right. So like when the movie came out, people were scared, just sitting in their room alone. वहाँ से कुछ निकल आएगा, कपड़े से कुछ निकल आएगा, right? It's so bad. It's playing on your mind. So if you can do this evil part that can do damage to you, if you do good part and strong part, would it not do good to you?
Yeah.
Yeah, so bad thing will do bad things for you. Good things will do good things for you. But the problem is, we humans, we are not wired to proactively focus on the goods. We only focus on things which are mediocre. Right? We prefer to have junk food, pizzas over healthy salads. That's why the warriors, you see the warriors, they're fearless because their self-image is strong. You see the Navy SEALs, they're fearless. They're ready to die. They're courageous because their self-image has become strong. Whether they may not be born in that family of the parents who successfully, you know, raised them, thinking and telling them that you are champion. That's what will help you to become champion on the calls. Right? I can come here and tell you what to say, but it's not going to matter to you. If your image is so weak, if you're not confident, if you don't have high self-esteem, none of the things which I tell you now in coming sessions, what to say and how to say will matter. It's just going to bounce off. Yeah, that's why people say cold calling is the hardest job in the world. But to me, cold call is fun. And that what people think is hard, for me it's easy and really a game.
Yes. Because we understand the knowledge.
Yeah, we understand. So we know the game, rules of the game, so we enjoy it.
Yes.
Other people just keep bumping their head in the walls.
Yes.
Right? Because they don't understand the rules of the game, cold calling, right?
Yes.
So that's what we're going to come and learn in coming few sessions as well. But you need to be prepared mentally to be ready to grasp the knowledge that I'm going to share with you and hungry and implement it. That's only way it will help you. Okay. So what is the solution? Number one is to become a champion. You need to think like a champion, which is the first step is mindset.
Yes.
You have to win the mindset. And by the way, this is not in any book. Usually, most of the sales book, they only talk about tactics or techniques, how to handle this, how to handle that. Nobody talks about the mindset that you need to have. And at the end of the day, it's a mindset that wins. So let's talk about the mindset. What are the things that you need to do? Let's talk about the rejection. So there was a time when I was doing, when I was starting my workshops and I started my coachings and trainings. And I was conducting workshops and webinars. And at the end of the workshop and webinar, I would ask people to sign up for my mentorship program or the service that I have to offer. And there was a period where I was not able to close anybody. And that closing, not closing is more painful than what you're doing right now closing. Because there's nobody who's going to come for rescue, nobody's going to pay you at the end of the month. Here, Taj will still take care of you. Even if you did not close anything in a month, you will still have food on the table. But when you are on your own, when there's no sale, there's no bills, I mean money to pay bills and family to take care of, right? So there was a time when I was getting rejection after rejection, right? Rejection as in no sign up, no sign up, no sign up. And on the other side, I was pumping a lot of money into the ads, into the venue, putting my own money in, feeding people who are coming for free, sharing all my knowledge. Nobody signed up for some time. I went back into my cave. I felt so rejected, so dejected, and I felt so bad, I took it to my heart. This is so bad. I think I really suck at this. I should not be doing this. I should probably go back and do what is safe. The reason why I was feeling terrible is because the rejection that I got, I thought that is a rejection of me. But I realize it's not a rejection of me, it's a rejection of what I have to offer. You see, there's a huge difference?
Yes.
Saying the rejection of me was the rejection of what I have to offer. How many of you have a moment? And this is one thing which I learned, that man, and this will happen time to time, again and again and again. Same situation. You go to a boy or a girl, your future partner you want to propose, and somebody rejects you, you take it personally. Oh, I'm not good enough. I am bad. No, it's not your rejection. It's the rejection of what you could have given to him or her. The life of the dreams probably does not matches with that person, with the expectation. It's not your rejection. But easier said than done, right? So you have to separate the rejection from the personal versus it is just part of the job. Some people were not ready to buy or invest. But if I don't understand this, and if I get hung up on only this, that every rejection is my personal rejection. Every time they said no, that means I am bad. If you start hung up on this, we will not grow professionally. So it's very important for us to separate the rejection from personal, you know, rejection to a professional. Right? If you can just do this, that will truly make you fearless. That will truly increase your self-esteem. And you know, you don't care. Okay, fine. You don't need it, no problem. You're not the only one in this world. Yeah. Right? If I propose someone, said no, no problem. Next. Or no problem. Next. There's so many. 7.7 billion of us. More than 3 million ladies. Right? So that's what you need to separate yourself. Right? And that's why you see ugly guys and beautiful girls. Those guys separated themselves from the rejection and said, next. Right? So there's a real example, okay? A lot of people think that I'm an introvert. Like, you know, most of the people think I'm an introvert. And sales is only for somebody who's an extrovert. How many of you believe that? Mm-hmm. Yeah, McCone, be honest.
Yeah.
Not true. Not true. Not true. The most successful people on this planet Earth, who were really champion at sales and who made millions of dollars, they all were introvert. 80% of them. Jack Ma, Elon Musk, Mark Zuckerberg, Warren Buffett, Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, and I can give you the list on and on and on. All introverts. How many beliefs just got shattered? To become good in sales, you don't have to be extrovert. You can be who you are, but you can still be damn good on what you do. That's when you know, when you're able to separate your professional rejection from personal, no matter whether you're introvert or whatever you are, you will always win. So here's the situation. There was one guy, real story, I read it in one book or someplace. This guy, he said, I cannot talk to strangers. And guess what? Being in sales, you have to talk to strangers every single day. Right? Write this Guru Mantra down. The Guru Mantra is, whatever you need in life, is with the stranger. Whatever you need. You want money? With a stranger. You want love? With a stranger. Until that, you know, stranger falls in love with you. Everything is with the stranger. How many of you are aha moment? Give a round of applause. So your ability to know this and understand this, that okay, there's no way out. I need to talk to strangers. So this man, he said, I'm an introvert. I cannot talk to people. I'm very shy. You know, I cannot approach, especially girls. What do I do? So his mentor said, Beta, come here. Here's what you need to do. You, today, you need to go. Here's a big park. You have to go and approach 100 women, 100 ladies. And you have to propose them. I'm an introvert. No, you're not. Just go and talk to everybody. Obviously, you cannot say no to the mentor. You have no choice. He went to the first lady. Hi, I'm so and so. Nice to meet you. Of course, shaking and all that. You know, heart racing like a bullet. Right? All that pulse and nervous and creepy and, you know, geeky, whatever it is. He said, I would like to have your number. Can I, you know, can we meet up someday? Can we catch up someday? No. Okay. Rejected. I'm bad at it. I'm so bad at it. I know I'm so bad. Nobody likes me. Girls don't like me. But still, boss ne bola tha, mentor ne bola tha, I have to go. So, he's like, he goes to the second lady. I am so and so, you know, I like, you know, this, can we meet up sometime? No. Goes to third person. Hey, I'm so and so, can we catch up and can we meet up? Here's my number. No. 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 90 of them have said no. But he still went on because he had a task to do. And guess what happened after 10, last 10? Any guesses what happened then? He got a yes! He got a yes after 90 rejections! And this man probably even wrote a book or something about it. How introvert is just in the mind. It's not about you born as an introvert. Nobody's born introvert, let me tell you. As a kid, you were not introvert. Let me tell you, 90% of you, none of you were introvert. You're shameless. You'll talk to strangers, you'll take candies from strangers, take money from strangers, you'll run away, you'll jump around. Your mommy, your daddy will chase you and hold you back. You're not introvert. But your human conditioning, education system, the society, made you to act in a certain way, and you thought, okay, I have to live like that. Oh, that is the way of living. I am an introvert. Damn. I feel shy talking to people. Well, choice is yours. The solution is, I am not asking you to become extrovert. The solution is, become situational extrovert.
Become a champion.
Become a situational extrovert. All these people I named, when they are put in front of the people, they became extrovert. When Steve Jobs stood on the stage, he had to talk to the world. They became extrovert, situational. When you are on the phone calls in a meeting, choose to be an extrovert. You do whatever you want in your personal life. But when that phone comes, it's your rifle. You just go and do the things that is required to do. You're a commando, you're a Navy SEAL. Handle the rejection, don't worry about it. Separate the rejection. And somebody says no, what do you do? What do you do? Next! Simple. It's not a big deal. The no is not the end of the world. Look, I will teach you how to reduce the probability of getting no. I will teach you. But despite me teaching you, you will still get no. And if you don't understand the way to handle the no, it will not help if I teach you how to get a yes. You need to learn to handle the no first before you learn how to get a yes. That's the difference between a mediocre and a champion. So that's number one. Give your neighbor a high five, say I'm a champion! Alright, so the step number two in mindset is love rejection. First is separating rejection, second is loving rejection. Love it. Like, we all love success, but we know if there is a day, there's a night. If there's good, there's bad. If there's short, there's tall. There's yin, there's yang. So be ready to accept the bad to have the good. So love rejection. It's okay. Talk to each other, say, huh? How many rejections you got today? Good man, good job. You got 50, I got 60. Right? We talk about success. Why don't we celebrate our failures? And more rejection you get, you know, more close to you are.
Law of averages.
Law of averages. See, the reason people become successful is not because they are smart. They become successful because they learn how to fail and fail fast. Aha moment. How many aha moment? Give us a round of applause. They do more things and fail at more things than you even try. People don't even try. You just do more and fail more, so you're bound to win. Right? I learned these from my mentors. And then fail big. Fail big. It's okay. And I know, knowing leaders here, Taj, he will appreciate. Fail, it's okay. Try, at least try to karo kuch naya. It's okay, you fail, no problem, try to karo. Because if you don't try and take extra effort to intentional failing, by default you will fail anyways. So you might as well intentionally put an effort and fail than not trying at all. Right? So aim for the sky. As Les Brown said, aim for the stars. If you aim for the stars, the chances are you may not end up in the mud. So shoot for the stars, aim for the stars. Try and get 100 rejections in a day. It's okay. It's okay. No problem. Go on to next, 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 next. Of course, now don't say that Dev ne bola fail ho to intentionally fail ho jao. reject me, please reject me. To make sure that you have the right mindset every time when you pick up the phone, there's something called Setting the intention. Yes. The right intention will lead to right action. Right intention will lead to right action. And right action will result in right outcome. Outcome. If my intention is, oh, I always get rejected, people don't like me, what kind of action would I have? Wrong action means, or no action. And if I have no action or wrong action, what kind of output I'm going to get? Bad, poor, horrible, miserable. But how many people set the intention when you start your day? Very few. Some of you do. Yes, good, very good. People who are setting the intention, good. Okay, so what should be the intention that you should set at the start of the day?
Positive mindset.
Positive mindset, wonderful. What else? What else? How do you, what kind of intention do you set in the beginning of?
I usually believe in setting targets for the day and mm-hmm. try to achieve it.
Okay.
If I achieve it, I call it a successful day, or if I don't, I do more the next day.
Good, very good. Having some goals that pushes you, does something for you, it's good. Rather than having no goals. That's number one. Apart from that, there is one more thing. When you say positive, let's go deeper into it. Set the serving intention at the start of the day. Like, I want to serve people. That's why I'm getting on a call. And ask yourself, why am I here? Why am I doing this? Because I want to serve people. With the intention of serving, what's going to happen? Even if they reject you, whose loss is it? Their loss. Because you thought you wanted to help them. It's their loss. But if your intention is not set, and if you really want to just sell, which is by default most of the people do, that they are supposed to act by default. Aana hai, call karna hai, ye karna hai bas. So what's going to happen? If they get rejected, they say, my loss. I didn't get the customer. Because the intention was not set. Right? So when I was starting making videos, initially people were like laughing and smiling and say, hey, look what Dave thinks about it, da-da-da-da. But I'll set the intention. My intention is to help people. It's not to prove that I'm a smart kid here and I'm a genius here. My intention is to help people. So I don't care. You reject my video, you block me, whatever it is, I don't care. And once I did not give up, they understood my intention was right. And the people I started attracting in my life. Taj also got connected with me through social media. How? Because my intention was right. To add value and serve. And I do that every day. Every day I wake up with the thought, who can I help today? How many people do that? They wake up with the thought that, hey, I need to go to office, I need to get ready, I need to brush my teeth, get bath and da-da-da, traffic and all. Aha moment? Aha moment, round of applause. You have a question? No?
No.
Oh, it's an aha moment. Good, thanks. People don't set their intention in the morning. Then obviously, you know, universe does not serve them. These are the main three ones. Okay. If you just work and focus on this every day, you're going to be awesome. You're going to be champion. People will look up to you and say, wow, where do you get this kind of energy from? Where do you get this aura from? People will want to connect with you. People will say, hey, let's hang out. Let's catch up. You start to vibrate at a different frequency. Everybody got aura, by the way. It's not only yogis, they have the aura. Everybody's got the aura. Some people have positive, some people have negative aura. The people who have negative aura, you want to stay away from them by default. Have you seen people, arey yaar, ye kyun samne aa gaya aaj mere?
Yes.
You know somebody like that. They have they vibrate on negative frequency, low frequency, dull, boring. You know, the life sucks. And you don't want any part of that in your life. Because your aura is positive. You're happy. You're cheerful. So you have to bring the positive aura. The only way it will happen is when you have the right intention. And the intention is not just set at the beginning of the day or the start of the work. You got to set the intention beginning of every new conversation. Every new conversation, because it's not a new conversation for you because the second call or 20th call or 30th call. Because a new call for that person from you,
yes.
If you don't set the intention for the next call, you will carry the same bad negative energy and negative aura to the next call. An aura can be felt even if it is not in person. It can be on the phone. Like, have you, can you identify somebody's mood by the tonality on the phone?
Yeah.
You can easily. You know, they're negative, positive, they're frowning, they're smiling. You can make out if they're smiling.
Yes.
Where this concept of smile and dial came from? From there, people wanted to. Now you know why people say smile and dial. Because your aura, your energy, your intention can be felt by the other person.
Right.
Even if they can't see. Like initially when I started my job in BPO, we used to have mirrors. We used to have mirrors. Anybody worked in BPO with the mirrors? Yeah, some of you did, right? Why? Because they wanted to look at, you know, when you're talking to a client, you look at yourself in the mirror and talk. So you notice whether you're smiling or not. And they have the post also smile and dial also.
That was very difficult.
Very difficult. Weird seeing yourself and talking and smiling. So weird it was. Some people started admiring themselves only. Oh, I forgot. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So smile and dial has a new extension. Smile and dial for dollars.
Ah. How about smile and dial to serve others so that you can make dollars and they can also make dollars?
Aha moment.
Yeah. That's awesome. Thanks, Taj. Beautiful. All right. So focus on your setting your intention on every call. And how do you do that? There's a formula to do that. Okay? When your bad calls happen and you're going to the next call, I just want you to just sit, close your eyes for 2 seconds or 3 seconds, and I want you to just repeat, release, release, release. What you're doing is you're releasing the negative energy and negative thought that you're carrying from the last call. This is what I learned from Brendan Burchard, very successful coach and trainer. He's trained some big names in the industry, big billionaires in the industry. So simple formula, very effective.
Some people count 1 to 10 to,
yeah, that usually is for anger.
Yeah.
Usually for anger.
Yeah.
Yeah. it works. Yeah, you can do that, whatever it is. Count 1 to 10 or say 10 times, release, and then you charge your energy up and go back in the battlefield again one more time. One more rejection. Bring it on, come on, bring it on. Is that best you got? Right, you go that with that energy, the next call, come on, you're gonna be, you know, happy and excited every day. Right? How can you not be happy? Right? I have seen people who are happy and excited in the worst of the jobs. Mundane jobs. Right? Chapati banake idhar phekna, chapati banake idhar phek rahe. Right? So, you know, what is so fun in making chapati? Right, but they're enjoying, they're throwing the chapatis. Right? Everybody's catching chapati and doing, playing and all that. It's fun. But 99.99% people in that job, they are bad. That's a chapati manare. That's how they make chapati. Arre khatu khaleva. See, negative energy. Everywhere it is energy. And your energy will decide how successful you will be, how wealthy you will be. If you have positive energy, you will get positive response, right? So setting your intention right for the call is vital every time. Okay, so put it on your wall, whatever it is, on kiosk, or what do you call it? Cubicle. Put some posters in your cubicle, which inspires you, reminds you like a trigger, to remind you like you're a champion, something like that. Whoever you admire, sports person, put that person's photo there. Remind yourself you have to operate like that person. Put something like, you know, smile or smiley or whatever inspires you to set the intention right. You've got to create the environment for yourself. Nobody is going to tell you, no, aaj sabke, no, and Taj will not say, aaj sabko smiley balls de dena hai. You have to take that initiative for yourself. And that energy will be so contagious, the other people will start wanting to hang around with you. When I was in a job, last job, man, if you look at the photo that I will share, I'll have Grant Cardone's photos there, right? He's like, success is my duty, my obligation, my responsibility. He used to inspire me. Like looking at his face, yes, success is my duty. Let's do it. All right. And then he said, no negativity allowed here. There was another poster. Saying somebody comes and throwing the negative garbage. And I said, dude, sorry, you can't do that. There's a no negativity zone. Any garbage that you have, take it there. I'll tell you, there. I know there's some negativity there. Throw your garbage there. You got to set your intention, your cubicle right. These are the things which matters the most. People think it's stupid until they know how much money the other person made. right? Until they know how successful that person has become, then they want to copy you, right? So become that leader, become that champion. That only will happen when you set the intention right.